Colston Hall in the middle of Bristol, and the arrival of His Royal Highness Prince Philip, the Duke of Edinburgh, stepping out onto not the traditional red carpet, but onto a green carpet, a symbol of this, the most prestigious wildlife film festival in the world, Wildscreen. This is the final event of the week, and the most important, the awards ceremony itself, in front of some 1,800 delegates and members of the public. A chance to see and reward the best wildlife films made anywhere in the world.
Tonight we celebrate the worldwide excellence in wildlife filmmaking.
This is the night to sit back and admire the skill behind some of the most stunning images we ever get to see on television.
Once thought to be a mysterious man of the forest, half human, half ape, orangutans are the least known of all the great apes.
With only enough energy to fly once and mate, they crash onto the water surface, pouring out their cargo of eggs as they die.
Like all prides, morus are a matriarchal society, a sisterhood of littermates, aunts, nieces. They're all related.
Like a politician on the stump, he starts to cultivate other members of the group, playing with babies, grooming females and infants.
As you've probably gathered, Wildscreen isn't just about awards. It's been a week-long festival.
To the heart of Bristol have come hundreds of people in the wildlife filmmaking business. They're here to learn or teach new filming techniques, to exchange ideas and attend seminars. Above all, to see films. Over 300 programmes were entered in Wildscreen 96, and of those, 45 were selected as finalists. Now those finalists have to be whittled down even further to the last three or four in each category. The deals and press conferences go on, but all eyes are on the award of the Golden Panda for the best overall film.